Alright, dickheads, I'm your Chunky Messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with a bit of an old brand new series. This time it's of The Lord of the Rings, The Battle for Middle-earth 2. On that there PC. Right, let's do a bit of an introduction here. For those of you who are not aware, and I wouldn't blame you because this is a, wasn't exactly, you know, a world beater back when this game actually came out, and this game came out 15 years ago, so there it is. Anyway, The Lord of the Rings Battle for Middle-earth 2 is, as the name suggests, the sequel to The Lord of the Rings Battle for Middle-earth 1, a game which I never played. Both of the games are real-time strategy games. For some reason, I almost said turn-based RPG. My brain's fucked. Real-time strategy games, published and developed by EA. That were made with the Lord of the Rings license. The first one was PC only and followed, from what I can recall, though again I never played the original, followed the events of the movies fairly closely, essentially letting you play out any of the big battles that were seen or talked about in the films, while this game, Battle for Middle-earth 2, went on a bit of a different approach. This one was also actually released on the Xbox 360, and it's on the Xbox 360 that I spent most of my time with it. I was absolutely enamored with this game back when it first came out. I played it literally constantly. It was just something I absolutely adored. I don't actually think I even played the campaign back when it came out. I just played Skirmish on this all the time, specifically on the Helm's Deep map. I had quite a lot of fun just like setting up enemy AI and getting them to just charge at Helm's Deep and just like allow my archers to destroy entire enemy armies. I just really enjoy doing that for some reason. This game has two campaigns as opposed to the one campaign of the original. Those two campaigns being, as you can see, the evil and good campaign, as well as a kind of, turn-based kind of grand campaign almost called the War of the Ring, which is exclusive actually to the PC version. The War of the Ring was not in the Xbox 360 version, and I've not really played the War of the Ring ever, and we're not playing it this time. The evil campaign and good campaign are kind of their own special deals, and again it doesn't actually explain it there, but the good campaign is, well, it's not canon, but it's kind of semi-canon. It essentially is an attempt at telling, talking about, explaining the events of, basically what was happening in the rest of Middle-earth during the War of the Ring. You know, in the parts where the characters weren't, such as Rivendell after they'd left, and the Dwarven holdings around the place, because, you know, the War of the Ring was kind of a global event. You kind of, as for in Middle-earth, you get, you'd get snippets of it in the books, but, you know, there's a lot of stuff that happens essentially off-screen, off the page, and that's what the good campaign's dealing with, essentially seeing how the other forces dealt with the encroachment of Sauron. The evil campaign, however, is essentially an alternate universe path in which evil wins, and it's you conquering every one of the individual kind of good areas. Both good and evil have multiple playable factions within them. Good, if I recall correctly, has your standard thing of elves, men, and dwarves, as you'd expect, with men actually accounting for both Gondor and Rohan, as that being kind of the majority of their forces, if I can recall correctly. Evil, on the other hand, as kind of an odd one, because it's got, the three factions for evil are what you'd expect is the forces of Mordor, as expected, the forces of Isengard, as expected, but then it's also just goblins, which is a weird one. I've always thought that was an odd one. And if I recall correctly, in the evil campaign, you spend most of your time playing as the goblins. It's a bit of a strange one. Okay, so before we go in, we are going to start on the good campaign, as much as I want to play the evil campaign, just because the good campaign, I'm saving the evil campaign for a bit of a treat later on. So we're going to play the good campaign, but I will say this right off the bat, this game is a bit odd. You may be wondering, if you're watching this series, if you end up watching this and decide you want to play this game, you may wonder how to do that. You know, where can you pick this game up? And the simple answer to that is you can't. Unfortunately, The Lord of the Rings Battle for Middle-earth 2 is essentially 15-year-old abandonware, because it was never really available anywhere digitally, it was only available on disc. I think there was actually a very brief period in which its expansion, Rise of the Witch King, was available on disc, was available on Origin, like a very brief period. But essentially, this game's entire lifespan basically happened, like, started and ended, while EA still had the Lord of the Rings license, but it started and ended before they really moved fully onto Origin. So unfortunately, there is almost no chance of this game getting a digital release, because it's one of those problems you get with licensed games. License expires, they just legally aren't able to sell this game anymore. So it is essentially abandoned. Where there are still copies of it floating around, I have physical copies of Rise of the Witch King and the original. I was lucky, I found them in CEX a few years ago. Both of them, which is quite good. It was the special edition, actually, as well. I think it was the special edition, because it had, like, a map and shit in it of the base game, so I'm quite happy about that. But these days, they are very expensive. I'm not going to tell you, you know, to go out and get it somewhere else, but I will tell you, it is essentially abandoned where there are means of getting it online, but that's up to you. I also actually want to point something out, which is quite amusing to me. One of the things, again, this is one of the systems in this game that was only actually available on the PC version, not on the Xbox, is the ability to essentially make your own hero within, you know, a handful of classes. You know, you got human, so you got Captain of Gondor, Shield Maiden of Rohan, elf, male elven archer, female elven archer, kind of limiting. Wizard, this one's wild, that you can make your own wizard of three types: Wanderer, Avatar, and Hermit, which is wild, which I think is basically Gandalf, Radagast, and not even Sauron, just an evil dude. You shouldn't be able to make wizards, but they are just for skirmish mode, so there you are. Dwarf Taskmaster and Sage. Servant of Sauron's, where it's like racial, so it's trolls, orc raiders, and Uruks, and corrupted men. So you have the Easterlings and the Haradrim. But yeah, you have all these options. Kind of some fun stuff. If I recall correctly, these guys are only actually usable in, I think, the War of the Ring game mode, and I can't remember the name of it, and the skirmish mode. But the odd thing is, you do have some kind of pre-built ones here. But I'm pretty sure that these last three here, Idriel, Berethor, and Hadhod, one guy will get that joke, and he's not going to watch it. I believe these are all the characters from that fucking awful turn-based RPG of Lord of the Rings, where you basically, Lord of the Rings the Third Age, I think it was called, where you basically play, you know, rip-off Gimli, Legolas with tits, and hi, I'm not Boromir. Chasing the Fellowship around, always arriving about 10 minutes after they left, and the game ends with you beating up the Eye of Sauron. It was a stupid, bad game, but for some reason, I guess just because it was a contemporary of this, they, as kind of an Easter egg, I guess, they put the party members from that game playable in this. Okay, I've talked enough. Let's go on the good campaign here. And, yeah, we're gonna go on medium, gonna go on standard, and hope that doesn't make me completely eat shit. Also, I'm super aware I might get copyright struck for this series.
In the final years of the Third Age, Middle-earth stands on the brink of destruction.
Also, the artifacting in this is in the actual in-game video, not in the recording, just so you're aware.
The Free Peoples are under threat from Sauron, the Lord of the Rings, who prepares his vast armies for war. At this late hour, the leaders of elves, dwarves, and men come together at the Council of Elrond to decide their next move. After the Fellowship is assembled and heads south to destroy the source of Sauron's power, The remaining leaders prepare for the Dark Lord's assault upon the northern lands.
Oh, 2005 graphics. Jesus, those character models. I remember this game looking a lot better than it does.
The elven races have always had little trust for each other, but now they must unite and fight a common enemy.
So yeah, Shadow of War isn't the first game to inexplicably give the forces of Sauron weird dragons. It happened in this game as well. Just, you know, for some reason no one really paid attention to this one, which always strikes me as odd. But yeah, this is a fairly classic style of RTS. It's not really going to surprise anyone the way this game looks and behaves. I believe it was built on a Command and Conquer engine. Like, I believe it was built in the same engine as the Command and Conquer games at this time.
Until now, this ancient city has been spared from the winds of war.
But not anymore. Now there's a load of shit.
Must go to the house of Elrond and inform the Lord of the approaching goblin.
Okay, I'm just gonna quickly, okay, I'm gonna be honest with you. I was really hoping there was gonna be a subtitle option there, but guess not. Okay, so we are currently playing as Glorfindel, and we have ourselves a force of warriors from Lothlorien. Okay, interesting thing, this game also essentially had, it had obviously your standard tech tree, as you'd expect from any kind of RTS, but it also had tech trees of spells, which were unique to the various factions. If I recall correctly, or powers, as they're called, I guess, not spells. The forces of good and evil, largely, each of the factions within that, largely shared the same tree, but they had certain unique things to them. For example, I don't think the dwarves can cast fucking elven wood. We're going to go with heal, though, as our first spell.
The heal spell can restore our soldiers' health.
Okay, and while we can, just going to take those guys. Whoops, okay.
I know these parts.
I'm trying to remember how to control the game. It's been a while. Also, I should say, I am actually playing this with, I believe, a fan patch. Patch 8. Fucking kill him! Fan patch, I believe it's like 1.9. Which also basically allows you to fix the resolution. This game, I believe, was not one that natively supported, 1080p.
They've never been so close to Rivendell. Be swift.
It's not a default thing. One of the things I will say that I quite like is the fact that any mounted unit in this game can get off of their fucking horse. Which I think is kind of an interesting one. And actually, this is from that that time period of strategy games, which unfortunately we've kind of moved past by and large now with you know, your relatively big strategy games. That time period of strategy games that. You know, here's the thing. I'm gonna send, let that force of Lorien warriors fight at those goblins, but have these ones over here.
I will not gain this field. Attack the forces of darkness.
Can we please?
We must protect the woods for the enemy.
Begging you. But that old tabard where essentially everything was visual rather than just being a stat bonus. You know, you see that with the older Total War titles, where you could actually physically see Medieval 2, I think, might be the last one that did this, where you essentially saw armor and weapon upgrades on the unit, whereas in, like, the game since then, you haven't. This was still, like, this was still in that time, in the olden days.
Your time is unmatched, Glorfindel. Ready, don't draw attention. Set
I'm trying to be, like, slightly tricksy. I probably shouldn't be, but I'm trying to be slightly tricksy with this. Okay, now we have all of our lovely, lovely elves. The game really is not making any attempt to teach me how to play it right now, which is Disconcerting. I might actually have to go do the tutorial on my own time just to make sure I do actually know how to play the bloody game. Yeah, the spells will operate on a cooldown rather than any kind of mana. I can't remember if they operate on, can't control it.
We must
gather. Okay, so we find Elrond and one thing. Okay.
Follow me.
You know what? I'm gonna put Glorfindel on his own. I'm gonna put these guys on their own, and I'm gonna order these guys to stand up here. There is definitely, I remember there's a way to put them into a formation. I just can't remember what it is. Yeah, I just genuinely can't remember what button that is. But oh well, I'll figure it out in time. Let's go talk to Elrond. To Elrond Hubbard over here. Who's that down there? Just a dwarf.
What brings you back so soon?
Oh, Glowit!
The goblins have come down from the mountains. They're approaching from the south.
As since this day was coming, long has Rivendell been safe from the servants of darkness.
It's wild to me they actually got Hugo Weaving for this. I know he was doing the narration,
but... I'll take care of the filthy wretches.
Train more warriors at the elven barracks to fight off the goblin invasion.
Okay, cool. We,
something is afoul.
Weapons ready.
Actually have these guys. Okay, so... Elrond's got a couple of bound spells there. He's got his own healing spells. So you know what? I'm gonna go send Elrond down here with these lads. I am actually, yeah, gonna keep Elrond with these dudes.
How long do we have?
And Glowin. I'll put Elrond and Glowin with those guys. And he's got just one of the auto casts.
The eye is fixed on Rivendell.
Does that heal him or is that a healing aura? Ah, well, just cast it there anyway.
You must act now.
Evil has spread across these lands.
Okay.
Train your warriors from this building here.
Okay, there we go.
The enemy is near. May our weapons be true.
Engage them!
Charge the fuckers! Ha ha! Oh God! Oh God! I was trying to figure out where the thing showing me what was being trained is, but Jesus fuck! It's like on top of the building. That's not fantastic. Oh dear! Forgotten some of the peculiarities of the game. Are you guys doing okay? I can't actually tell. I think you guys are doing okay because you know goblins are falling, and there seems to be a hell of a lot more of you than them. So I'm going to assume you guys are doing okay. Ah, good. Glowin leveled up. Good lad.
I will face them.
I don't think you can like customize your characters as they leveled up. I think it's just a matter of
keep your wits sharp.
We bring swords from Lorien.
I think that's just a matter of
the eagles of the mountains have seen the goblins approaching. They have sent word to Gwaihir and are now on their way to lend aid.
Okay, good. The eagles are helping. I don't know that the eagles are necessarily anywhere near us, but I'll take it. That doesn't sound good. That sounds like drums in the deep, personally.
Now
I'm not...
The weapons be true. See the enemy.
I thought we probably couldn't be happy about that one. Said many times, as I've said before, drums are never a good sign. Oh, I think one of the wild, big horrible beasties that the, yep, there it is. Is that like a hill ogre or something like that? I can't remember what the hell it's called. But some giant, horrible, ugly thing that's very angry at us. And of course, you know, we got our more classic cave troll. Oh wait, can we see it? Mountain giant, that was it. Big horrible.
They're invading.
To give it its technical title.
Take this arrow.
They attack.
I've returned with the lantern.
I'm just going to real quick. Get Elven Wood there.
The Elven Wood spell provides an armor bonus for any allied units, as well as providing camouflage for elves.
We've destroyed a goblin camp to the west of
something
here.
Is afoul.
time.
There are more goblins setting up camp across the river.
I do not fear death. Courage is with us.
Sound the alarm! Goblins are coming! They're just beyond the river!
We must ride out and clear the valley of the goblin filth.
Cool. Let's just send out these other guys and we'll keep good old Glowin and Glowin and Elrond over there to look after the city there. Send Glorfindel and Arwen. Out.
The enemy has made camp here.
We must not let go of hope. Quickly.
The enemy is here.
Cast them out.
Evil has spread across these lands.
And go fuck him up.
We must protect the woods.
Is that good? I mean, it's an eagle, but it's like big and black, so I don't trust it. That sounded racist. I thought about it. Oh. The eagles are for some reason heroes. Okay. Let's.
We must act now.
We have much to do.
We must ride out and clear the valley of the goblin filth.
An end to this.
Let's do that then. Sure, whatever. And since I actually reckon that our big fight's gonna happen over here. Put that elven wood stuff there. I mean, the goblins aren't really doing a particularly great job of paying much attention to us. You know, one of the things I always absolutely adored about this game, and it's always one of the things that I love, is just like the amount of little animation detail there is on the buildings. Like this little guy. I love this guy who always crawls out of the goblin cave. I fucking love him. I mean, he's dead now. He's been really horribly murdered. But, you know, I loved him before he died. It was a good sort up until the point at which he died.
The enshrouding mist spell can hide our troops from the enemy.
Yeah, fuck it, let's just pop down some fog to fuck in the enemy there. We are so close to casting a healing spell, it's making me nauseous. I really just want to hit something with a bit of healing. I mean, it doesn't seem like it's going to be particularly important. I mean, I think I'm pretty sure these lads are fucked, you know what I mean? I feel like we've won. I almost feel sorry for the goblins being picked on this badly by these eagles, man. I mean, one wouldn't think eagles were this effective at destroying buildings, but I guess they've got a reason to be mad about it.
It's a worm! We must destroy it!
Now our weapons
it
be
is our out.
There you go, everyone, beat up the worm. Oh, that's why it told me I should probably use eagles. Alright, fair enough. Because it does, oh yeah, a hell of a lot of damage to stuff that's on the ground. Because there's a lot of elves that just horribly died from fire. But we won! Cool. Okay.
Under siege from the goblins of the Misty Mountains, Rivendell is no longer safe for the elves. As time is now running out, Elrond forms a plan to unite the elves and dwarves of the north against Sauron's advancing armies. His most powerful warrior, Glorfindel, will join forces with the dwarf leader, Glowin, to make war on the goblins and forge this alliance.
Sick! And, okay, next time, gonna be doing that mission. Okay, I'm gonna go, because it's actually quite, late. I just realised I'd forgotten to record today, so I decided to, record this before I went to bed. Ideally, before I record next time, let's just quickly Ideally, before I record next time, I will have done the tutorial, so I'll remember how to play the game. And hopefully this catches people's interest. I do notice that people actually tend to prefer watching me play kind of older and more obscure stuff that that mattered more to me back in the day rather than more modern stuff. I guess because who the fuck's talking about this now? You know what I mean? Who's going to even be thinking about this? But yeah, so... More of this? Yeah, probably not tomorrow, based on my normal upload schedule. Day after, whatevs. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.